data I looked at was discovering past methods of food and fibre production, which targets the year 3, 4, 5 year level. Middle primary, they talk a lot in the Australian curriculum about that they have a better understanding of the world outside of themselves, and so that's really got their first sort of dip into looking at the bigger world, like looking not just at our small community, but looking at Australia. The bit that I really enjoyed about this was there was a big focus on Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander perspectives and on sustainability. Those two aspects of the curriculum are huge, but also I particularly enjoy the sustainability focus because it's looking towards the future and what kids can do to help preserve the environment. Kids, even in a small school like ours, it's that they know that they can have an impact on the future, but also on the environment and on how things develop as they grow older. We have looked at Aboriginal perspectives and the primary industries related before, but not with such a strong link. And I think that this helped the correlation to be seen by me in particular a lot stronger. And so therefore the kids can see how it goes together. And it just all fits nicely in together. I am not necessarily the most confident person teaching Aboriginal perspectives. So it was really good to have that background information as part of the unit. And some links to make it a bit more real, like with some video links and some good reading and things like that for the kids. Because we were looking online and we were looking in all different types of media, so it made it a lot more relevant to the kids rather than me just talking and giving them information. And they were doing a lot of discovering of their own as well. There was one part in particular that I really liked, and it was that they encouraged the kids to interact and work collaboratively and to give them time to imagine and then to bring everything all together at the end. So I just think that was really strong, to give them the time to imagine what could be, what could have happened, what are the possibilities. They really enjoy this sort of learning because they can look at history and then they can bring it forward to the present and where they are now, and then they can look towards the future. So it's really meaningful for them because they enjoy looking at local history as well as like Australian history. Because farming is such a strong employer here, like there's a lot of farming families around, and so it's a lot about what they know now, whereas the history and the future thinking is so important. They could see some of the past mistakes that have been made and some successes, and then they could see that that's where some things are built upon and some things there's been damage made, and you know, like there's some things that are not around now because of past mistakes. And then looking at the creative side of how what they might be able to invent one day or what they could do to help the environment. This particular unit was focused on design and technology, history and geography, but I found that I could also link it myself, like through English and things. We were looking at a lot of timelines and we were looking at, you know, lots of different stories and Dreamtime stories. So it crossed over a lot in different areas as well. I hope that it motivates them to look into the history and to also think more about the future of not only farming, but just our local area and Australia as a whole, really.